Welcome back to Psychology of the Unknown, where we do videos on true crime, ghost stories, and psychology. So if that's what you're into, then don't hesitate to subscribe for more content and slaughter that notification bell. Don't forget to give our videos a like, share with your family and friends, and leave your manifesto in the comments below. Today we're giving you a rundown of the top 10 serial killers from California.
We don't want to do anything to scare your children. That's the last thing we want to do. We don't want to scare anybody.
That's Kenny 911. What is your emergency? Thank you. Caller, what's the address?
At number 10 is Luis Peet, who murdered at least three men in 1912, 1920, and 1944 by way of shooting for financial gain. She was sentenced to life imprisonment on February 17, 1921, and paroled on April 11, 1939. She was then arrested again and sentenced to death on June 1, 1945. She was executed in the California gas chamber on April 11, 1947. At number 9, Dorothea Helen Puente, who poisoned between 3 and 9 elderly and mentally disabled boarders in order to cash their social security checks from 1982 to 1988. She was sentenced to life in prison without parole on December 11, 1993, and died in prison on March 27, 2011. Number 8 is Holly Ann Grigsby, who is a white supremacist that killed 4 men and women by way of shooting from September to October of 2011. She was sentenced to life in prison without parole on July 15, 2014. Number 7 is the Zodiac, who murdered between 5 and 37 individuals, mostly couples, via shooting and stabbing from the 1960s to the 1970s. He was never identified and is still at large. At number 6 are the Hillside Stranglers, Kenneth Alessio Bianchi and Angelo Bueno Jr. The two kidnapped, raped, tortured, and murdered via strangulation 10 women together, while Bianchi murdered an extra 2 on his own from 1977 to 1978. They were both given life imprisonment, while Bueno died in prison of a heart attack on September 21st, 2002. At number 5 is Chester Turner, who murdered 14 women and an unborn child via strangulation from 1987 to 1998. He was apprehended on September 30th, 2003 and sentenced to death. At number 4 is William Bonin, better known as the Freeway Killer. He raped, tortured, and killed between 14 and 36 boys and young men via beating, stabbing, hydrochloric acid, and strangulation from May 28, 1979 to June 2, 1980. He was arrested on June 11, 1980 and executed by lethal injection on February 23, 1996. At number 3 is Richard Ramirez, who is better known as the Night Stalker, who murdered 15 women using a wide variety of weapons, including handguns, knives, a machete, a tire iron, and a hammer from April 10, 1984 to August 24, 1985. He was apprehended on August 31, 1985 and sentenced to 19 death sentences, but died in prison by way of B-cell lymphoma on June 7, 2013. At number 2 is Randy Kraft, better known as the Scorecard Killer, the Southern California Strangler, and the Freeway Killer, who raped, sodomized, mutilated, and murdered between 16 and 67 young men between 1971 and 1983. He was arrested on May 14, 1983. He was then given the death penalty on November 29, 1989, and is currently on death row at San Quentin State Prison. At number 1 is Juan Corona, who murdered 25 migrant workers by way of knife and machete through stabbing or slashing from February 1st to May 19th in 1971, and buried them in shallow graves in a peach orchard along the Feather River in Sutter County, California. He was arrested on May 26, 1971 and received 25 life sentences with possibility of parole, but was denied a parole 8 times. He developed dementia and died on March 4th, 2019. At 85 years old. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss a single video. Give us a like, leave a comment below, and please share the video with your family and friends. I've been Shannon, and this has been Psychology of the Unknown.